with a sentence that most of the states, when they look at ICT with a project, Gujarat looks ICT with a framework. That is a basic difference Gujarat is making in this world. And while creating the framework, many hands have joined and sensitized different levels for taking these efforts further. Computerization started long back in Gujarat, but the concentrated approach towards e-governance started in 1999. I will just tell you about four basic points, taking the overall view of ICT in the state, about the policy framework in the state, the infrastructure for which the Department of Science and Technology and GIL is responsible, e-governance applications. We have seen four or five applications earlier. The championing, the basic champions are the departmental secretaries for this, and capacity building, which is also happening at department level as well as across the state level, converting karmacharis into karmayogis. So, two faces of India we can see here. In urban India, we know that there are 295 million population, and in rural India it is 804 million. But out of which, for e-governance, the target beneficiary is 159 million in urban and 483 million in rural area. When we have created IT policies, different policies for website, procurement, developing the solutions, creating and maintaining the websites, asset management, security, and all that, certain goals they have, which we have kept were for citizen and business interactions, were government at doorstep of citizen, reducing the visits of citizen to government offices, streamlined, standardized electronic information gathering and access, thereby making government 24/7 for citizen and reducing the time to decision making, electronic delivery of services to meet citizen expectations and requirement through 100% online submission of all the forms. We have yet to achieve. It's a long way to go. Convenient anytime, anywhere citizen services, and develop enabling technology environment even for e-commerce. For inter and intra-government interactions, we have taken up the standardization of the processes. Here I will just quote one example. In Gujarat, we use bilingual, most of the applications are both in Gujarati and English. Databases are available in Gujarati. Take it as a land record system, or maybe civil supply system, sir has said, or let us take it municipal corporation system, tax payment and all that, or birth and death system. We have multilingual system, even budget. So if different departments, if they use different fonts and different packages to create the Gujarati files, it is very difficult. And that's why a simple standardization of standardized front end across the state, standardized fonts and standardized data communication mechanism, that has standardized the processes. We have improved internal efficiency, as increased employee productivity, reduced system maintenance and training requirement by adopting standard systems and processes, reuse of the databases, cost effectiveness in the operations of government agencies, better enforcement of law, effectiveness of planning and schemes and tracking the benefits to the user, resulting in improved governance. Here, the listing of different IT policy framework, which has started since 2004, like hardware and networking system integrator policy, hardware maintenance policy, total solution provider policy, training policy, condemnation policy, software testing policy, website development and maintenance policy, Gujarati font standardization policy, security and asset management policy. So this is the framework. On one side we have government departments, board, corporations, and on other side citizen and industry, and DST and GIL, the nodal agencies for implementing the project, starting with the initiatives with definite strategies and approach. So if you look at ICT at a glance in Gujarat, for e-infrastructure, three basic components: Gujarat State Wide Area Network, State Data Center, and eGram. For applications, more than 200 applications are there in the state, having G2C, G2G, and G2B. And future roadmap, standardization of content, process re-engineering, and cost optimization, and still consolidation. We are now starting the POC of cloud computing also. So these are certain future requirement, and citizen impact is effective public reach and better health, education, and lifestyle. So what was our journey year by year? In 2002-03, all the departments, they started putting their information on websites. So this is information. Then we started the interaction by query from database and two-way communication, inquiry-based exam results, grievances. We have heard that Swagat started in 2003. Transactional system started in 6-7, like delivery of services to the citizen. City civic centers came in 2005-06. E-Dhara project, totally online, came in 2004 and enhanced in 2005-06. And now it is totally re-engineered in eJamin. Paid services, one-day governance, and then the transformation started in 2008-09, like faceless and 24/7 government, online portal, one-stop shop for citizen-centric service delivery, and collaborative and shared databases. And now the time for us is converged infrastructure, mobile and telecom in governance, IT and infrastructure optimization, cost efficiency and reconsideration, virtualization and cloud computing. So this is the current scenario in 2001, JISWAN, 2003, Swagat, 2005, Integrated Workflow and Document Management System, 2006, Value-Added Tax System, 2007, Hospital Management Information System, Financial, Integrated Financial System in 9, and HDIITS, and some other systems like eDhara, eCity, registration, eGram, and procurement, and many more. So basically, the infrastructure part I earlier mentioned about wide area network, data center. Earlier we had server farm, but then the data center came in 2008. We have common service center in Gujarat, it is eGram, all the villages, not one in six, and ATVT project, that is Apno Taluko, Vibrant Taluko, in each taluka places. So these are certain broad statistics establishing new benchmarks in the connectivity. State to district center is 34 Mbps bandwidth. District to taluka center is 10, and district to district is 34. And on internet side, we have 71 Mbps bandwidth available today. And the users, if we see, people started, they were in the learning curve for first initial years, but in last 3 years, the number of users on GSWAN are more than 32,000. Just 4 application statistics I have taken to see that how effectively people are using the infrastructure. This ATVT project just started from 1st May 2011. Jan Seva Kendra's old project, eDhara, also earlier, and Record of Right, Only this four project has given the revenue in 1 year of 47 crore. Each transaction cost is 5 rupees or 10 rupees. So we can imagine that how many transactions are happening using this wide area network. These are certain standards, features, and in of data center, but the latest activities in the data center, they are virtual cloud environment, virtual private cloud, and migration of SDC network, GSWAN, and all component from IPv4 to IPv6, it is under process. SDC is also set to acquire ISO and certification for processes and services as per the international standard. Out of 18 processes of ISO, we are through with 10 processes. EGRAM, this is transforming Gram Panchayat to Gram Sachivalaya. This exactly is the how it works. Airtel Bangalore hub is there. And this is the EGRAM NOC at Gandhinagar. 13,695 remote locations are connected. And video broadcast as well as video conferences are also happening through this EGRAM. I would just like to give an example how effectively these EGRAM centers are being used. Last month, Honorable Chief Minister announced a project called Khel Mahakumbh. This project is for developing the spirit of sports in the state, in all categories, all ages of people. And in record 23 days, 18 lakh plus registrations have happened from EGRAM centers. 13,000 centers, this many registrations have been happened. So this effectively they are using. This is bringing all government activities under one roof. Apno Taluko, Vibrant Taluko. It is also creating more transparent and efficient citizen-centric system. It is implemented in all 225 talukas. As on today, 150 services are available on intranet. Our efforts are to take maximum services on internet through portal. So these are, in nutshell, various applications. Like if we consider health department, like eMamta, health management system, school health program, telemedicine and 104 and help desk. So far as e-governance infrastructure goes, I have already said that it is upgraded to 4 Mbps to 34 Mbps in all 26 district center, 2 to 10 in all taluka center, and 4 to 34 in all 6 clusters. So as on now, more than 72 Mbps internet bandwidth is available. If you look at agriculture and environment sector, soil health card, AgriSnet, e-Krishi Kiran, extended grid node, these are certain projects. Forest management information system. Look at revenue, e-Dhara, e-Jameen, Apno Taluko, Vibrant Taluko, city civic centers. Sir has explained about ration card, birth and date, data entry applications. And if you go to education sector, then 2D, 3D content-based multimedia software, district information system for education, Gujarat Knowledge Society, and Nirmal Gujarat Techno Seva program, or online student registration to result processes. These are broad applications. Every year, in any of the session, if we go with our application, people without fail put a word that Gujarat must be there with one or other project. Because officers in the state, senior bureaucrats in the state are taking the responsibility, taking the ownership of the project. And we are fortunate enough to have such kind of environment at top level, at administrative level, to take up this project and get the encouragement. If we have infrastructure, if we have applications, if we have projects and databases, but proper capacity building is not there, then we cannot achieve anything. So fourth important component of e-governance is the capacity building. In Gujarat, any new entrant in the government has required minimum computer literacy. But those who are in the job, they are also supposed to take some minimum computer literacy level to operate the existing system in the department sectors where they are working. And their promotions are also linked with the passing of the examination, the modules which are developed and declared by the government. So capacity building at all the levels, at awareness level, at functional level, as well as at management level is happening in the state. So finally, I would like to say that we are enhancing the value proposition by effectively containing the cost. So paper systems are now almost towards digitized system. Silos are single window. Few channels, now we have any channel. Multi-level, we have integrated part. Passive is now engaged and mass is now customized. So cost of delivery and value of citizen-centric service has got at normalized level of the services. Thank you very much.